Sunshine, shake on it. Uh-oh. What it bees like, this your boy, the superstar, the superman. 13 love, 13 wisdom, 13 knowledge, and 13 respect to you and yours. 13 love to everybody who's part of TLC. 13 love to those who still haven't got inside TLC. I know y'all said, I'm tired of hearing this joke. I'm going to kick your ass in the kitchen. I know y'all gotta understand me, though. I still got a lot of stuff going on. I fought some battles, won them battles. Still got some battles to finish completing everything. Because I'm fighting a couple of battles on different front with my son, too. Won that one. You know what I mean? Nah. So everything's looking up. Only what you can do is look up. You know what I mean? So check this out. Y'all ready to have some fun? Yeah. I've been in a risk state. 30 love the bro Rio. If y'all still haven't got ID cards, go back to nature. Get back to nature 13. I think it's back to nature 13. Go see brother Rio. Cause Rio, get your ID cards and stuff up. Alright. Yeah, I had Rio was kicking on the phone, so we're gonna do a video together and stuff. And all the moderators gonna get all y'all together and gotta do some things, you know. A lot of plans. All right, how can I start this? Because I want to get some heat. I ain't gonna get the heat. I'm gonna leave the heat for the Million Man Marchers. Let's talk about a story. When I tell stories, these stories all have something to do with messages in these stories too. But since we have these gurus and these teachers out here, and these people that think they have some knowledge and they don't know who they are, I'm gonna make this one a kind of short video and tell you about true American history. See, it still deals with this new age deception, as we deal with the Abra Pike deception. And Abra Pike was also the general commander of the Civil Confederate rights, right? And he was the founder of the KKK, right? Told you this story before, right? So when you get these Moors, and you have free Moors, and then you have some unconscious Moors that became dirty Moors that forgot who they are, was like fighting with the Confederate. You had some on the north side too, with the Union, right? When you get the leaders or the elders of these family members that had homes that was over here, so you got to realize since 1492, the Moors have been fighting with some of the European, them so-called Jews people that came and manipulated everybody. They got to fight and stuff. You thinking of the Indians and all that kind of stuff. Indians means end, I-A-N-S, or E-I-N-S. That's the end of your E-I-N-S. You lost your ancestral inheritance with the E-I-N number that IRS talks about in your trust. E-I-N number. End of it. So that's where the Indians come from. But you ain't heard nothing yet, buddy. You thought you was a guru. Put that one in your pipe and smoke it. When you're dealing with the wartime, so you had a lot of elders was killed off. So a lot of the leaders or the wise ones of the so-called tribe or so-called beehive, they was killed off. So they didn't get a chance to teach the youth, pass the message on. So we used to leave messages orally. And we left messages and songs and psalms and stuff like that. So a lot of messages and a lot of history got twisted up, and it was done on purpose. Because when you're going to war and stuff, who's going to teach the children? They come in and kill off the elders. Who's going to teach the children? So then they can implement any kind of education they want to give you until you came from here, you came from there. So the children are the ones who grew up and think they came from somewhere else. And it's all fake knowledge. You see what I'm saying? So now let's look at this. When you got this group of people, let's just play down sounds. See, because there wasn't no slavery. I told y'all this stuff. See, the cotton movement ain't started in the 1800s, really, right? See, when the Moors was over there in Europe and everything else, right, they dressed nicely and stuff. They had cotton clothes and all that good stuff. So the New Age seven royal families that's in power today, and we call them like the Queen of Windsor Castle, which I told you was a Nazi, but now it just come out in 1933. She was Hitler. Just came out. I told you this, but you ain't hearing though. Vatican Nazis. You didn't hear it though. See, everything got twisted upside down. So you think about the swastika, but the swastika is the wheel, the Ezekiel wheel of life, and it spins in four different ways. But you ain't heard nothing yet, because you thought the swastika was Nazi, and it's the Ezekiel wheel of life. You ain't heard nothing yet, baby. So dealing with these ones that was left in charge of had property and stuff in so-called Mississippi or Alabama or Georgia or Kentucky, wherever they had so-called slavery acts. You can have property. You can have, like in Africa, you can have a lot of land, all this property. You ain't got no money. You ain't got no wealth. You got land, but what is you growing on your property? When you don't have no farming skills to grow no crops, how you gonna survive? Y'all don't hear me though, do you? See, trickery is deep. So when you got people going to war, and then after the war is over, and you got some people get confused on who they are, and you still got some free man mowers out here that like they don't get involved in that war stuff, you know what I mean? Because they dealing with the sultan, you know what I mean? Because they don't deal with the kings and queens, we deal with the sultan of Morocco, you know what I mean? Because who sits on in Morocco right now is a king, and he works for Rome, he's not the sultan, you know what I mean? There hasn't been another sultan since, you know what I mean? Well, people think they got knowledge, you know what I mean? Play with these people. You got land, you got property, but you can't grow nothing. So here comes the swindler. See, when everybody's going to war, you have the so-called Jew swindler going around into the neighborhoods, and they get them a do-boy, bring like a little more back home from Spain that can grow some crops and teach them, you're gonna be my do-boy to talk to them in Hebrew or whatever like that, da-da-da. And you get them say, man, we're gonna plant some crops on your property. So they plant crops on their property. And the Europeans say, hey, little boy, you know, I'm gonna share the profit with you. Matter of fact, I'm gonna give you a couple of dollars up front, some silver coins up front. So that's sharecropping, which came to be slavery. It was sharecropping. So the Negro got some little, so-called Negro got some little, Dirty Bird got some little money now. So now he got some money to go down to the little store and trade goods and get some of the things he need. You know what I'm saying? Because he wasn't growing no food. See, if they would continue growing food, they would have bartered with each other. Like TLC, we're trying to get people to barter with each other. But see, they lost the ability to barter and farm and share with their neighbors like it's supposed to be done. So here comes this man in. Next thing you know, he got the deeds to his home. Matter of fact, hey man, since I'm running this show here with all my cotton crops and everything, y'all got to get out the big house and go out there to the back house with the food and stuff like that because I work York for me now. It's your property, but you don't forget. Because you illiterate, you don't speak the English language, you just signed a contract, sharecropping. And you getting just a share of the crops, but you ain't even getting that. And you're still saying to yourself, oh, you don't know that, you don't know no better. And then they come up with another idea, say, wait, let's trade them around a little bit, like trading places around. So you trade, go down to Farmer John's house and go to Farmer that, that, that. So now you don't got traded around and families get messed up and everything and you don't even know nothing now. Now here it is 100 years later. We ain't even 100 years later, from 1802 to like 1865, with some style waking up and all this kind of bullcrap and said, man, they end up like so-called slavery, and them gave this word called slavery, which is servitude on your own goddamn land with sharecropping. Y'all ain't heard nothing I said there, have you? Sharecropping. And after that, you really lost. And then some other ones come over, the children of these people and came over here, and the ones that came was all businessmen. They all was businessmen, so-called Jews, that stole the estates of some of the Moors, ate them and drunk their blood. Yes, blood eaters. And it was demons. And some of these ones who let their property be sharecropped saw crazy things happen at nighttime because they saw sorcery. They ain't know what the hell was that. They saw some people getting taken in the dark, getting the blood sucked out of them. So a lot of them started running into the woods, getting the hell, man, we gotta get the hell away. They started trying to run up north, they started trying to run here and there. They wasn't running from no goddamn, no so-called master or somebody with a whip. The motherfucker running from demons that they saw, because demons was released then in 1492. Them demons got stuck, it's coming on the earth. Y'all ain't heard me that, did y'all? Go look up, you. They try to give you a little hints in that movie by Abraham Lincoln that's fighting them demons and stuff. They try to give you some hints, but y'all ain't hear that part. Go ask an old person. I talked to a 90-year-old grandma and stuff. She said, hey, man, that one, these people use some evil stuff out here. I said, I know, grandma. I know. They just don't know. Grandma broke it down and told the truth. She was born in the 1920s. And she knows the stories from her grandparents. She came from the areas. Said, them all lies. And that's why a lot of older people won't even talk about that stuff. You might find an Uncle Tom and somebody like talk about that crap like that. And they talk about some slavery, some bullshit. There ain't no such thing. Them paid people. Paid that. The act, just like they do these little fake shootings and stuff like they got paid actors out here. Same thing going on. The Jew is pacing by it. And they try to hide the truth about the demons and stuff. And the demons that he got, they vampire like people that suck the blood of others. But you don't believe in that stuff. But they talk about demons and jinns and shaitans and all around the world. But over in America, they're like, oh, man, that shit ain't real. All that bull crap. You know what I'm saying? But a lot of the so-called black people is under some kind of illusion and disillusional, thinking they come from slavery and then they look for handouts and all this bull crap. When you have property, you still got the property, but now you're starting to give up 100 years back up. So you're about to give up all your inheritance to the land because you don't follow the Most High ways. It said, come out of here, my people. You got the inheritance to the land. That is your trust. In God we trust. The treasure is the trust and dealing with the people of the land. But once you start thinking that you're not from the land, thinking you're from somewhere else, you don't give up all your trust. And once you start following demons and devils and you don't follow the Most High, so you gave up all your trust. And everybody out here is doing it. Then we got the agents want to take people on a million man march. March again like some goddamn ants, some little sweet ants. Why don't you take all that goddamn money for a million man march and put it into a goddamn trust bank? But you ain't hit me though. How much money would that be? That's enough to start a big goddamn more bank. But you ain't hit me though. Because y'all just going to listen to these damn agents who are going to sell you down the river again. I told you, Emmett Till, time. Y'all ain't healed nothing. It's going to light your ass up on time again. From the 60s to the 2015, it's back in that spiraling eight. You're marching again. You're going to go down again because it's going to start riots. And watch the big person get burnt. Pow! You ain't heard nothing I'm saying. And it's going to be the final one because it's ushered in his last 7 years. I wonder what you're going to do. Barbecue or mildew. Is you going to follow the lawless or go with the righteous? Because the people in the 60s and 70s who got side on the black power shirt, getting on the drugs, having free love, and all that bull crap. Hey, we was hippies. Which the hippies was nothing but a hip pie. You was hip to the American lie. I mean, American pie. So you bought into the American lie. I mean, pie. Hippie. Men having sex with men and free love and all. Oh, new age love. It was a test run in the 60s. Get your LSD and hallucination drugs and stuff.
Oh, love you, flower child. I love you. I love you.
All of some damn drugs. And here it is, what, 40-something years later? I don't know how many years later they do it again.
Oh, new age, love you again. I love you. I love you. Let's have sex with men, having sex with men. And boys just say, oh, we're just all the same.
And it ain't hip. It ain't hip pie no more. Hippie, it's hip-hop now. And the hip-hop is spreading this gender, homosexual gender. Men sleep with men and boys sleep with boys. All that bull crap. The same thing with weed again. Same thing with some kind of pills and drugs and hallucination drugs, bath salts and everything. The same goddamn thing, right? But this time it's the real deal and you about to get it. You about to get knocked out like hell of a Holyfield. His name is not hell event. Oh, it's going to be a hell of events coming, about to get ready to happen. Fourth blood moon coming. You've been warned too many times. You seeing all this stuff, you got it. They demons got it to order now. I ain't trying to scare you, I'm trying to prepare you. But I'm just giving you a little history to see where you're coming from because you wasn't slaves. You gotta let that go. You can't be worried about this all black person, white person, let that shit go. Everybody your cousin around the planet. So I don't know if I should break down the spirit thing here. Now I'm gonna do that one next because I don't want these videos to be that long. So we're gonna just call this off. I don't know what to call it, but sharecropping nigga. No, I'm sorry, nigga mortis. You nigga got nigga mortis out here. Negro mortis on you. You and mortis. You. Already dead. That's just keeping it real. I know you're gonna get mad and stuff, but go look it up. Because you listen to these goddamn liars out here and all this stuff thinking you come from Africa. Hold on. You didn't call yourself an African. Africa is the continent. What country you from inside Africa? What nation? What province? Where? Ah. But rather than your constitution, rather than Articles of Confederation, all different parts of congressional meetings and House of Representative meetings and everything, it shows you Moors. It shows you Moors. It shows you Moors. It shows you Moors. That's it. You can't be nothing else or you're going to be a slave. Because the Sultan gave George Washington the rights. Say, but in fact, check this out. When they did a mandate to do business over here in the land, and they went by the other treaties of Tripoli and all this kind of stuff, barbarous treaties and stuff like that, to try to stop the Moors from robbing the ships and all that kind of stuff like that. And the Sultan say, you know what? You take use them over there and take some of them over there because they ain't going to do nothing. So a lot of the children over here that don't do nothing, but they're here talking, these are the ancestors of the Moors that weren't going to do nothing. They're dirty Moors. See, because the Sultan like, take them and get them over. They ain't going to do nothing. They sell out some switch outs. See, because real Moors that stood up and fought, some of them stood up and fought. So they were like, they was a Muslim, but some of them switched out and turned to Christian, or they got their head chopped off. Some of them got in the wind and went to the islands because they was righteous and the Most High led them, right? But today, we got a lot of crossbreed out here, Moors. You know, I don't know what the hell they is. Because one minute they talking some knowledge, next minute they're getting mad at some police shoot. Moors is the lawbringers, obeyers, and stuff like that. They bring the law and law enforcers. But you forgot the law and you still partake and watch Rome when you're supposed to be getting your political status and start making laws and taking over each town, taking over each district. That's what you're supposed to do, but I don't see the Moors doing it. I see they still trying to compete in Rome's system when you know you're not supposed to be part of Rome. You can do business in Rome, but you're not supposed to be part of Rome. You're supposed to be doing your own thing. I don't see nobody doing it. That's why, you know, I would love to see Moors take the empire back and get the planet running back on the right course, but it's not going to happen. That's where the 13 comes in. Death and rebirth. I mean, come on, man. I would love for it to keep going, too. I would love the world, but I've been here enough. You know, so it is what it is. You know, come on. Everything's dying. The planet's dying. Everything's dying. It's time for judgment time. I don't know what y'all think it is. You know, a lot of y'all don't know nothing about this because I ain't gonna talk about the spirit on this. I'm gonna do this one. I gotta see the spirit just for next because I gotta be deep on that spirit stuff. So a lot of y'all just don't know because y'all ain't connected to the planet like I am. You know, you're not connected to the universe. You're not connected to all souls or not souls, all spirits around the planet, all the people. That's why I have no hate for nobody. That's why I don't see no such colors on somebody that's so black and so called white and all that bull crap. I see a person and I see the aura field or whatever in and out that person. I know who they are. And I know who the children are. If you was able to rise to 13 and start using 13 in your name and incorporating that means you got something to do with the bloodline. You know, that's just real talk. Anybody else, they on something else. They dealing with them seven royal families. See, I can go deep on these people. Them seven royal families are the seven satanic families that have misrepresented the whole planet, and they're Nazi families. They're Nazi, they can't see through the future, they're dealing with the reptilians. They're coming from the seven deep blowers of the abyss. But I've been telling people, y'all ain't ready, I ain't gonna give it to you yet. But I'm gonna take the seven floors down deep, the seven abyss realm. Because y'all think that, I told you seven upside down is a L going backwards left. Because somebody went backwards and went left. They didn't go right, they went left. So you got caught, you got tricked. Yeah, I know seven C's. I feel you, I hear you. I know seven chakras over six, 13. I hear you. Yes, I know the Moors coming out, so I think the seven thing, the seven, da, da, da. I know all this, right? Seven cardinal points, whatever. Yeah, I know this, right? But it's seven royal families that really run the planet. And they tricked everybody and took over. And these old ancient royal families were not real royal. It's just they've been around longer than the real ancient people. Because they deal with the reptilian kind. So they've been on the planet before the planet. Like, I mean, they go deep. And they finally say, well, it's our time to rule again. It's only a very few of them. That's what they call it, the shadow government. Skelly skin bastards. You know, I keep telling y'all though, Queen Ho, y'all think it's a joke though. It's deep. It's on a very few of them. They're trying their best to try to let that thing go on. They know they can't rise up. They can't go nowhere. They know it's over for them too. They know they'll be willing to keep some humans out here with us. Please let us know. You know, that's all. You're on the lowest you ever been. But all starts with that sharecropping stuff. And you've been tricked ever since then. And once you start believing that you was in slavery and all that, you believe that history, you something wrong with you. That Jim Crow movement, and you still right back here today, still about to burn up, about to catch it because you're not listening to the Most High. Most I send messages. You know, some of us, like I tweeted, some of us are divine individual interventions to stop things before they happen. See, Satan lives in the now, and he deals with man. Because man don't give a damn, and he lives in the now. He just wants everything now. He thinks he's doing what's going on now. But he don't see himself in the future because he's not a divine being. The Most High lives in eternal. The most Satan lives now. That's it. He can't see himself in the future. But the Most High sees or knows everything. So like in the movie Deja Vu, Denzel Washington wants to go, they're trying to do something to go back four days back to stop something happening that had happened already. And he dies when he came back, but he really didn't die because he's already in the future still. You know what I mean? So, but he knew exactly what was going to happen when he went back. You get it? So somebody like Christ is somebody from the future who went back and walked amongst the men. I'm just giving examples. So for example, let's say 13th son comes, right? Out of nowhere, right? But he says things in those days that other be laughing and joking all the time. He knows things before they're gonna happen, but he try to keep it because he can't have the government on coming. Like, man, they wanna know. So he plays it off and jokes with you and all that stuff, but he give them hints and he ain't been wrong yet. And he tell you they're gonna happen, they always happen. So that's like somebody already seen the future, right? And they back and said they came back to help try to intervention or whatever. Can't get everybody because all of them ain't gonna make it, but that's a few that came out. It's a few that get saved. But wasn't your Bibles written and said the same thing? I'm just saying. You can't save them all, but you can save a few. He think he know it all. I know that a lot of y'all some false prophets and some false healers and some false devils out here, some Jezebels that ain't got no message, ain't got no connection to the Most High. I know that for a fact. And you misleading a lot of people with your little illusion and delusional mind, think you got some powers and you got no powers. I know this for a fact. That I know. So please take heed when some comes amongst you, an organic seed, an original seed, and he links back up with his brothers and get deep rooted with his brothers and get them back on the same track too. And they start coming together, and them right there gonna be them righteous ones and trying to help you. Just take heed, all right? TLC, 13 love. It wasn't no slavery. You was sharecropping and you lost your land because you was dumb. It is what it is, don't get mad at it. Try to get right and get your land back. But you can want to get back because you claim to be something else. You're not. So you can't get the land back. All right. I got this little demon fly just came out of the way and he running around the thing like a racetrack. Like, you can't see me. You can't see me. 13. You can't see me. I'm going to knock this. You know what? I ain't going to play with your demon. I'm going to rage your ass. Like, God dang, I'm going to flew his butt in for somebody out of nowhere. Just, you can't stand the This your boy, the Super Son, the Super Man. And that's not in the whole story. I just want to tell you because a lot of people think they be talking all this, who you been slaving? We don't use a goddamn lie. Your ancestors, your grandparents, whatever, had some property and you couldn't take care of your property. You couldn't grow, and you still can't grow no seeds today. You still can't plant nothing today. So you still need somebody to come on you and give you some food to eat. Now think about it. You can't grow no seeds. You can't grow no food because you was lazy. Or you just want to go to the club or something. Show you. You lost conscience. You don't know who the hell you are because you can't grow no food, so you can't eat. Think about it. Sharecropper. You shared your crops on your land. And you can't do nothing there. You can't build that. You have no patience. Think about it. It's your boy, the Super Son, the Super Man. 13 love, 13 wisdom, 13 logic, and 13 respect. And I'm going to come back with the spirit information. All right.